شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Dhil Nurain Online Islamic Institute presents Ramadan series, in which we will be talking about the month of Ramadan in order to prepare for it and spend it in the most optimum way. For this, we will be talking about various topics in relation to Ramadan, its virtues, fasting, its benefits, different rulings regarding fasting, and of course, the sunan of how to celebrate and prepare for Eid. So let us begin with our first episode of this series, where we will be discussing Ramadan and its virtues. The month of Ramadan is a very special month in Islam. This is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chose for the Muslims to fast in, which is one of the five pillars in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this month of Ramadan is the month in that which the Quran was revealed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us in the Quran, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودًا, that He calls Ramadan a few days counted, meaning it comes once a year and it's only for a few days. So we need to take advantage of that time when it comes. And this is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send down His greatest angel, Jibreel alayhi salam, to teach His greatest revelation, the Qur'an, to His greatest messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, He would come down at night and sit with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and recite to him the Qur'an, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would recite to him back. This is also the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to Islam. The greatest battle took place in this month, the Battle of Badr. And in this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen a very special night in which He sends down the decree. This is a night known as Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down His decree for the rest of the year. This is a month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every single night releases people from Jahannam. This is a special month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has closed all the doors of Jahannam and opened the doors of Jannah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us that there is a gate in Al-Jannah known as Ar-Rayyan. And this is a special gate that only those who used to fast for the sake of Allah will be able to enter. There are many other virtues of this blessed month, but we need to also ask ourselves, what are the goals of fasting? What's the reason we fast? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that fasting has been prescribed upon you, meaning the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as it has been previously prescribed upon the nations before us, for one reason, that we may gain taqwa out of our fasting. And so the purpose and the goal that we want to make from our fast is to build taqwa with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And taqwa has many definitions and many depths, but to cover it at a general level, taqwa is when you put a barrier between you and that which will anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Lord, He's our Creator. He is the one who provides for us, who wakes us up in the morning, who puts us to sleep at night, who gave us this life, and who will give us death and resurrect us and either enter us into Jannah or enter us into Jahannam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from Jahannam and to enter us into Jannah. And so taqwa is a very important part of a Muslim's life and is the goal of fasting, to gain taqwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us through our fast, how can we gain taqwa when we restrict from our desires, when we hold ourselves back from that which we desire, like food and water, and if you're married, relation with your spouse. This helps build the taqwa in the heart when we control our desires for the sake of Allah. And so this is the goal that we want to get from our fasting. There's a lot more we're going to discuss related to Ramadan. But before that, let's get into some preparation for Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as narrated in many ahadith, would fast the most in the month of Sha'ban, which is the month right before Ramadan. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith that the fasting between Rajab and Ramadan, which is the month of Sha'ban, is something that a lot of people neglect and don't take advantage of. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would fast most of the month of Sha'ban in preparation for Ramadan, getting in the spirit and getting in the mood for Ramadan. And many of the companions and the later generation, they would say that the month of Sha'ban is the month of preparation for Ramadan, and this is the month of fasting, and this is the month of recitation of the Quran. Because when you enter Ramadan, you already have a schedule and you already have a habit, and so you'll continue it and increase it. Versus if we wait till Ramadan to start our fast and start reciting Quran, then we're going to be behind and we're going to find difficulty. So we try our best to start before Ramadan while we can in this month of Sha'ban. One very important aspect of Ramadan is moon sighting. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ. Whoever witnesses the month should fast. And as we know, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go out every single month of the entire year and sight the moon. And in Islam, the calendar is based upon the moon. And so a month can either be 29 or 30 days. So on the 29th, Muslims go out and we look for the moon. We look for the new crescent of the month. And it's very simple. If it's seen, then the next day is Ramadan, meaning Sha'ban finished 29 and the next day is Ramadan. And the second option is that we can't see the moon due to fog or due to overcast or any other reason that prevents us from seeing the moon. Then we complete Sha'ban a full 30 days and then begin Ramadan after that. And so this is of the sunan of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He would go out and view the moon. And this is ibadah in itself. If we go out in our local communities, even if we get together with our local community at the masjid and try our best to sight it, just to implement this sunnah and to get the reward for it. Now, if the moon is sighted, then that night is Ramadan. As we know in the Islamic calendar, the night comes before the day, meaning the first of Ramadan would start from after Maghrib. And the next day, 24 hours later, would be considered the second night of Ramadan. And that time between would be considered the first day of Ramadan. And so how we Muslims start Ramadan, if we've seen the moon, is by praying Taraweeh. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the hadith that whoever prays behind the Imam, Salat al-Isha, and he continues to pray with him until he finishes, whether it's 20 rak'ah or 11 rak'ah, but he sticks with the Imam until the Imam finishes, then he will get the reward as if he stood in Qiyam the entire night worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is very important for us Muslims to follow the Imam and stick with the Imam, whether he is leading 11 rak'ah or 20 rak'ah, but to stick with him until he finishes, so that we can gain this reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let's discuss a bit about the suhoor. Suhoor is the meal that we eat before the time of Fajr enters. And as we know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his diet used to consist of dates. This was a part of his daily diet throughout the entire year. And so of the sunan is to eat dates when you fast. And if you see the date, it has a lot of nutrition. And so the Prophet ﷺ sometimes would only drink water and eat dates. And this was sufficient for him because there's so much nutrients in the dates. As well as making the intention that this isn't a feast that we're having. Rather, we want to have a small meal in order for us to have energy to fast the rest of the day. And the Prophet ﷺ told us in the hadith that there's barakah, there's a blessing in the suhoor. So even if it's small, and even if there's only a few minutes left till fajr, have something light because there's going to be barakah. Allah will bless that meal. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ told us that Allah and the malaika praise the person who eats suhoor. And so this is something beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he sees his slave waking up and having a meal before his fast. So fasting begins when the time of fajr enters. Meaning, when the time of fajr has entered in your locality, then you are not allowed to eat or drink anything after that. Your fast begins from that moment. And your fast continues until the sunset, the time of Maghrib. When the sun sets, this is the time that we break our fast. And as the ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ tells us, that the Prophet ﷺ would be very quick to break his fast. He would rush to break his fast. And so this is something that we also try to strive for. As soon as the time enters, we break our fast. Of the sunan of breaking the fast is to first break with dates. And if you don't have dates available, then with water. And this is what the Prophet ﷺ used to do. As well as the Prophet ﷺ used to recite this dua,
ذهب الظمأ
وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. Which means that the thirst has been quenched and the veins have also been quenched, and that the reward has been written, inshaAllah, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the end of our first episode. Please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to get notifications for our next episode. Jazakumullahu khairan.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه